In Toronto, we might not experience all of the negative aspects of climate change, but we're definitely contributing to this climate change problem. We just, in general, are not overly sustainable in the way that the city is set up. We either have huge condo towers that are covered in glass, that just are not energy efficient at all, or we have these suburbs that everyone lives so far apart, you need to drive to get anywhere, and neither of those are sustainable. The issue with condos and being such high density, you don't have the roof area available to put these solar panels where you're living. It's not inherently able just to produce as much electricity as it would want to consume. EcoStudio is a multidisciplinary team of students and faculty from Ryerson University and Seneca College, and we're all working together to create sustainable homes.
I think what's really interesting about Zero House is that it's not just a single family passive house. It's really an urban housing prototype designed to sit over a commercial space at grade and to reuse existing urban infrastructure. The units themselves are designed so that they have two orientations each. So they have an entrance on one level on the north side. There's a common entry porch that people enter the unit from. We also have a generous indented courtyard that allows for east light as well.
I was the lead student designer working with Cheryl Atkinson, my professor, on the design that she had helped come up with for the Zero House. It has zero carbon impact through its construction and design and emissions. It's going to use zero energy on an annual basis based on what it's producing on solar photovoltaics. It has zero toxins embedded in any of the materials in the construction. There was also next to zero waste produced in its construction. All these things together, combined with the fact that there's close to zero cost premiums on the house, all maintaining architectural design and a beautiful place to live.
Partnering with Endeavor Center really made the project possible. And Endeavor Center is an organization that trains people to build sustainable buildings, and they do a pilot project each summer, and this became their pilot project. What was really remarkable was to see how quickly that whole building did come together. It was shipped into Toronto in a flatbed truck, 16 panels, and craned into place in a single day on site at Edit DX. And the rest of the cladding, both inside and out, was installed over the remaining 5 days before the show opened. It was remarkable.
One thing that sets Ryerson apart is the drive towards this out-of-classroom experience. Being at Ryerson, it's not just about doing a degree, it's about doing your degree and applying that to other areas that are not actually in the scope of your degree. I worked with the architecture faculty and the business faculty on top of working with the mechanical engineering department. Everyone really seems to want to work together towards common interests. We hope the solar block is really the beginning to the answer to the sustainable urban living question.
The value that EcoStudio has added to my education here at Ryerson is enormous because it gave me real-world experience working with contractors and working with my professor Cheryl Atkinson, who has been working in architecture firms for years and knows how these things work and can help guide me through that process. And that sort of knowledge going into industry out of my master's degree is going to be indispensable.